I'm giving the Nokia 928 phone test video at 1080p indoors in a mobile light studio. This happens to be a real $100 trillion bill. It and the other bills were bought for an economics project on super hyperinflation. Back in 2008, super hyperinflation gripped the Zimbabwe economy. In November of 2008, there was 6.5, 10 to the 21st percent inflation. Because of the hyperinflation, this paper became less valuable than this paper. And this paper here is less likely to plug up the plumbing than this paper. This situation caused massive economic chaos within Zimbabwe. Zimbabwe went from being the breadbasket of Africa to having food riots. And it was recently reported that the Zimbabwe government had the equivalent of $212 in the federal treasury. The situation got so bad that in 2009, Zimbabwe abandoned its own currency. And even today, at the time of this video, Zimbabwe doesn't have a national currency. Zimbabwe also issued bearer checks. The interesting thing about the bearer checks is they have an expiration date. This one was supposed to be used on or before the 30th, June 2008. Here's one for $50 million. In addition to the bearer checks, agriculture checks were also issued. The agricultural checks were supposed to be used only for farming, but found their way into general circulation. Here's one for $5 billion. And in the back here, you have pictures of grain silos, which, given the food riots, probably were empty. Got a $50 billion, $25 billion, another $50 billion. This one for $25 billion. The agriculture check for $100 billion. Again, has the grain silos on the back. And here we just have a $1 bill. I'm going to go get the $100 trillion bill. So here we have the $1 and the $100 trillion bill next to each other. The difference between the $1 note and the $100 trillion note is greater than the difference of one American penny and Bill Gates' total fortune at its height.